As the country battles the COVID-19 pandemic, the UP National Institute of Physics managed to score a historical milestone. Last month, Reginald Bernardo became the country's first homegrown gravitational physicist after being quizzed by some of the most brilliant minds in the field. He now joins us live to talk about his feat. Reggie, good afternoon. Reggie, are you there?
Good afternoon.
Hi, good afternoon.
Yeah, I'm here.
The country's first homegrown gravitational physicist. How does that sound? How does that make you feel?
Nakakagulat. Still, I'm not sure really how to react. I never expected that the treatment that followed my defense. I mean, I would expect a treatment for rock stars and movie stars. I mean, influencers. But I mean, come on, a theoretical physicist and one working in the field of gravitational physics. It's great. It's great to be distinguished, and the encouragement from very many private managers. Great, and many students of science need the support.
Well, for us, you're a rock star in the field of science. I was able to watch part of your defense, and I heard from NAP's, I think it was Professor Ian Vergara, describing you as an heir to a proud tradition that traces its roots from Galileo, from Newton and Einstein, all those popular rock star names in science as well. But how does it make you feel? How does that sound being named along them?
Come on, that's really great. I mean, any one of us knows Einstein, Galileo, Newton. We all know about them, their works. We're familiar with the universal law of gravitation, universe square distance. I would be happy to be mentioned with them. It's a great honor. And for a Filipino to be mentioned with them, We should be very, very proud as Filipinos.
Reggie, I tried to read up on your thesis defense. Of course, I can't understand them. But
yeah.
But will you be able to tell us a little bit about it and explain it to me, maybe not as a grade schooler, but maybe as a high school student, and tell us the significance of this thesis?
I don't mind, thanks. So we Filipinos of basketball. We watch the UAAP, we watch PBA for games, of volleyball as well. Many of the games, gravity is there, and it affects every one of us. It's the reason we enjoy watching Kobe Bryant shoot the basketball. The same force that makes the ball fall when we throw it up, that's the same force that governs the rest of the universe. But we don't understand it completely yet for cosmological distances. So imagine having a ruler that is 10 to the 20 times longer than EDSA. So light would take around, 300 million years to get past that distance. Mm-hmm. So we don't completely understand it yet for those distances, and we want to understand this, building on the works of Einstein and Newton, of course. So that's what we want to do, and that's gravity. It's the reason why Earth is the third planet from the sun. It's the reason planets, stars, black holes are formed. It's the reason why the universe is expanding. So we want to understand that.
Interesting how you compared it to basketball to make it sound more interesting to a lot of people. But thank you very much for trying. How did you get first interested in this field, in science?
Thanks. Not really sure that I mean, it's been a long time. Don't really remember when exactly, but as far as I've always been interested in science. It's been my favorite subject since elementary high school, and well, this did not change even when I entered the seminary, and then when I left out and transferred to UP Diliman, it even got better, got more interested when I met actual non-fictional scientists for the first time. I love science always.
That's good to know. Now, Reggie, you prepared for your defense during a time of a pandemic. How did you actually prepare? And did you think that staying home helped you more in preparing for this, or did this limit your studying, researching, and communicating with others?
Well, it was difficult to prepare for.
Reggie, go ahead.
Well, it was difficult to prepare at home, actually. I mean, you don't have the same environment as in the lab in the institute. It's more difficult, and no one expects the PhD. No one expected the PhD defense to be done remotely. But then I guess even then, may advantages din naman, and we were able to reach a lot more people and be encouraged with their many words. I guess it's fine. Though it's difficult. I mean, you don't see your audience. I mean, if the defense was done in the auditorium, the talk might have been a lot more easier because I see my audience. I would know exactly how to interact with them, but then the defense had to be done remotely. Well, there's no way around that.
Reggie, you now have a doctoral degree. You've graduated magna cum laude and published 12 papers in top international physics journals. We do want to know what's next for you.
So I'm going to do my postdoc for a few years. Really start a scientific career. So to get to even starting point in this career, I have to build more of my expertise. And so my plan is to work on more on the cosmological aspects of alternative theories. So that's that. So postdoc for a few years, and then definitely going back to our country, and then I'm building my expertise in mentoring students in here.
Okay, that's good. Thank you very much. Reggie Bernardo, the country's first homegrown gravitational physicist. Congratulations again, and thank you very much for talking to us.